All right, so this is our fifth. Is it our fifth game in the road? We're almost back home. So yeah.
Lots of energy.
We'll do this. We'll do this real quick. Another shoot around. Another damn shoot around. Okay. Let me get this shit straight. Haven't made a chance to hit a three-pointer lately. Gonna make sure that's on deck. Clutch. Damn, look at that smooth. Damn, two in a row? Give me that. Make it three in a row, baby. Oh. We'll do five. Oh shit, that's not gonna go in. That's two for four. One more. One more, dog. Pound it. Ah, oh, shit. Oh, he gave me right away.
And in the locker room, each guy has been going over and through his own routine to get
them. The floating phone back comes back.
They're one single unit. If it's the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame, it can only mean one thing. Welcome to Cleveland, Ohio. It's Thursday night, and it's the NBA here on 2K Sports. Along with Greg Anthony, Brett Berry, and our sideline reporter, David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan. We've got a quick moment now to take a look. Hey, Dave.
Well, Kevin Love has dramatically improved his perimeter shooting over his career, but he said, I've tried not to fall in love with it too much. Where I'm going to make my money is also rebounding. That's a stat I always look at. Because it can help a team win, even when the shot's
rebounding,
not falling.
Huh?
Kevin?
Great attitude. His work inside, a big part of it, D.A. Thanks. And the guys
we're
up
coming
front
off of a 70-point game, which is pretty sick.
What elements make for a fantastic front court?
Well, nowadays it's about skilled front court players, guys who have the ability to not only shoot it, but also dribble handoff, make decisions with the basketball to help open up and spread up your offense for your guards and your quicker players to slash and find those gaps.
And now the Lakers starting group. Up front, it's Kuzma and Davis. Shea is out there with Rajon Rondo, and it's LeBron in at the three. And for Cleveland, Clarkson is the two with Osman the three. The duo inside, Love and Thompson. And it's Garland in at the point guard position. Now, here's Garland.
Oh, shit, he got baited.
And no one near Clarkson as he lets it go. Gets the three-pointer to fall.
Clarkson draining one from deep, something he has to continue to work on. Stretch out the floor.
Passes it to Kuzma. To the middle, stolen by Thompson.
Now, we're facing another bad team, but you never know.
Pass to Clarkson, the tray.
Yeah, you ain't making two straight, dog.
The Lakers with the rebound. Last time they met was in Los Angeles.
Not a close contest either. The last time they got together, everyone in the rotation played solid, and the bench was the difference.
Well, the second unit came in last game and just played lights out basketball. I'm sure they'd like to do that again.
Here's Clarkson following the basket by Anthony Davis. The pass to Osman. Pass to Love.
Oh man.
And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul. And in the summer of 2018, Kevin Love signed a four-year, $120 million extension to remain in Cleveland.
Yeah, and Kevin right now is the bridge from what was to potentially what will be. And in that what will be scenario, what will be happening is Kevin Love probably gets traded at some point. But he's been great for Cleveland. He's been a great ambassador for the city. The things that he's doing off the court philanthropically have been amazing. And Kevin Love is not done in the NBA. Still another team out there for him to go to and contribute to.
Uncovered at the rim, finding cracks in the defense here early on.
Just really smart basketball and exploiting whatever holes that he's seeing right now in the defensive squad.
And you know what? He doesn't mind getting his hands dirty when it comes to really fighting on the backboard.
Not only fighting on the boards, he's converting, and not just on the putback. It's a great start for him.
Now here's Love. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against Sacramento. Shot, high post. Tries again. Thompson.
All right, they're not going away, huh?
Nice job in the glass as they pick up two on the second effort.
Now that's okay. What Tristan Thompson does best, just working the glass and working the D over.
Shea drives in, and Shea throws it down.
And the one-hand slam just looks so pretty when it's in his hand, and he's the one.
Oh, he popped it.
Agreed. He
holy shit, okay.
Silk, even on a power finish.
Love is awesome at reading the defense, and they're not up on him. He's going to let it rip.
Shea left side. Looking for Kuzma.
Risky pass, though. Oh, shit.
Another shot. And it's Davis missing. The Cavaliers leading by four. To the inside. Garland. Lead pass was put in just the right spot.
And their offense already in a flow. Some stellar shooting to jump out to this lead.
And here's James. He'll bring it up for the Lakers. Jay kicks to Kuzma. To the paint.
Oh, look at that sweet move, baby.
I mean, it looks simple, but LeBron makes it look that way, Kevin.
Cleveland's gone 2 or 3 from deep so far in this game. Garland, the pass to Osman. Kuzma against Love. Here's Garland. His last outing, 16 points for him. Pass to Clarkson. On the clock. Here is Love. By Jay, over Rondo.
Yeah, but, yeah, violation right there.
Second shot clock violation. They turn it over. Lakers trail by four. The drive by Jay and the dunk by Jay.
You just cannot have any fear. Once you commit to taking it to the hoop, Jay showing some guts.
The Cavaliers have gone 5 of 8 from the field, shooting over 62%. Here's Clarkson.
Fuck that.
Jay with the block.
Oh, man, hustle, though.
Cleveland will retain possession.
What the hell?
Love against Kuzma.
And with AD roaming around like a great white shark, smells blood in the water, makes
oh
the
my
defense
goodness.
Think twice.
Pass to Clarkson. And another shot.
Things are going south right now. This is not the type of shooting that his teammates expect from him. Well, if he's going to keep shooting, they've got to run some plays for him. Screens, pick and rolls, anything they can do to get him started.
And that's how to make an impact with defense. Once the steal is made, you know they're going to be scattered.
Jay passes to Davis. Second chance shot, and Jay lays it in. Jay's got 10.
A lot of questions about Jay and his effort in college. If he continues to do things like that, that'll go away.
Now, here's Garland. He's covered by Rondo. Garland with it. He's certainly been a consistent piece of their offense, averaging about 14.5 points a game. And that one is good.
You gotta know that
first time in a couple of games that we've been down in a while.
Inside.
For the Lakers, they won their last contest, that game against the Raptors in Toronto.
Yeah, mental toughness on the road. The arena was rocking. But they just got down to business and never let up.
Impressive to see them on the road just step up and have that kind of offensive performance.
Here's Garland following the basket by Jay. Lock at six. Osman kicks to Love. Another three for Cleveland.
Wow, unconscious has he been this quarter. They're riding that hot hand.
Lakers trail by five. Down low, stolen by Garland. Clarkson with the ball. He's picked up by Rondo.
A pretty good hustle. Clarkson out on the break. He can be dynamic there.
Lakers have gone 8-12 on field goal attempts so far.
You think about the Cavs and the two MVP awards that were won for that franchise. Of course, that was LeBron James in back-to-back seasons, both in 2009 and 2010.
And stolen by Jay.
Nice, all right.
The glass.
He's got almost 16. Didn't take over.
Yeah, that's the third bucket in a row from the paint. This defense needs to clog those
without calling a timeout. That's crazy.
Garland, the pass to Thompson. Here's Osman. Shot clock at 6. Clarkson on the wing. Takes a 3. Shea with the block.
Crazy to think scouts were saying that Shea didn't play with enough heart. That block showing you that he wants it.
All right, let's do this.
Now for Cleveland.
They're fucked now.
Shea has checked in for Thompson. Nance comes in for Kevin Love. And it's Matthew Dellavedova in for Clarkson. And Los Angeles will go for a different look here. DeMarcus Cousins is checked in for Anthony Davis. Howard comes in for Kyle Kuzma. Danny Green, he's checked in for James. And it's Alex Caruso in for Rajon Rondo. Los Angeles shooting their first free throws here tonight.
A relatively rare trip to the free throw line for Green, averaging just one attempt per game over the course of his career.
And then, in 2013, with Miami, LeBron Brent finished one ballot shy, burning all the MVP votes.
We wouldn't see a unanimous MVP winner until Steph Curry did it in 2016. But just as impressive, if not more so, LeBron James with a total of 4 MVP trophies over a 5-year span.
Nance, no good.
And what should have been a simple pass and finish ends up in a missed opportunity on that alley-oop attempt.
Yeah, you'd like to keep things a little more simple, and that was a play that didn't quite develop the way they wanted it.
So far, both teams scorching the Nets. You gotta love it.
Yeah, made for TV game here. Pace is great, scoring is coming in bunches, and both of the teams feeling confident right now.
Now, here's Garland. Nice D from Cousins.
And the effort never stops with him. No easy shots when he's on the floor.
Well, it's about the defensive end.
All right.
Put guys' feet off.
It's what we expect in a team takeover.
At all times.
Yeah, a nice, strong finish on the inside.
But Greg, that's what he does. He's got the dunker mentality. Here's Garland following the bucket by the Lakers. Knocks it loose and stolen by Cousins. And pushing it up, here's Los Angeles.
And the wow.
Good.
Unnecessary roughness.
Flat out taking the game over, and there's no way he's going to give it up.
You often hear about players talk about their favorite spot to fire from on the floor. How much of an effect does that really have, the favorite shooting spot?
Most of the time, Kevin, what you're talking about is star guys, because they're the ones who ultimately, in any given possession, the coach is trying to find that guy in that spot to do something. What happens throughout the course of a year is when that player has the ball there, everybody else knows what to do.
Right.
Like the player knows what he's going to do, right, Kevin? Because he's the star player. But everybody around gets comfortable with the options and where it is that he goes. If he goes right, if I slide right, I'm going to get the 3. If he goes left, he's spinning back, I might move towards the top of the key. So the familiarity of not just the player, but the players around the player, that's where you can make it happen.
That's interesting. Howard misses.
And typically he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession.
The Cavaliers trail by 3. Now, here's Garland.
Like the work from Dwight on that play. Some good attention on that defensive possession.
Garland, no good. Cousins, the pass to Shea. And he comes up with the deuce. Shea's got 21 in the game.
Man, 21 first quarter points, huh?
To get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them. They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
And the rejection by Cousins.
How about Cousins with some gritty defense there, showing off his intimidating length on that rejection. Making the easy shots and the tough shots. He's on top of his game.
Cleveland's gone 3-4.
They're going to call a timeout.
3-point land so far in the ballgame.
No one calls timeout just yet.
Now here is Dellavedova. Tight defense on him. Osman kicks to Dellavedova. And Garland has it in the corner. Pulls up on the wing. That shot misses. And the Lakers going the other way now. 1:22 left in the first. Shea passes to Cousins.
Oh my goodness, he just posterized Larry Nance.
Wow, how about that?
That was ridiculous.
Showing a little something special. Tremendous again.
Look at this muscle.
With style.
Dunk on that boy.
111 left to play in the first quarter. Garland, the pass to Austin.
Oh, swat that shit out of here, bitch. Let's go, G. White.
And it's Howard finishing it off.
I like their focus coming in. Terrific execution so far.
Well, if there were four or five boxes to check in terms of the game plan tonight, they might have
checked. Damn, that escalated quickly. Turned the tide around.
Here's Dellavedova. That one falls.
How about Telly getting pinballed around out there, but good body control to get that one to go.
Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws.
And I like the fact that the defense is looking to protect the rim at all costs.
Henson checked in for Cleveland. The Lakers also making some changes. JaVale McGee's checked in for Howard. And it's Avery Bradley in for Alex Caruso. 32 seconds left to play in the first.
Well, you have to like their work on the boards, Kevin, particularly here to start the game.
And then Cousins with the dunk.
Man, 26-6 run just like that. Thank you, Team Takeover.
Yeah, the bully ball tonight has paid dividends. Highly effective down there with the physical play.
Here's Osman. 9 points last game. The wide open look here for Garland. It's hauled in by Jay.
I didn't see that miss coming. I mean, he's usually been money from that range.
And he banks in the layup. Jay's got 27.
27 first quarter points. That's crazy.
His game, do the talking. He's pouring it in right now.
And so it's the Los Angeles Lakers. Their lead at 15 going into the break. Their transition game has been in full effect. And don't go away. We'll be right back. Cleveland. Ante Zizic has checked in for Henson. Love comes in for Nance, and it's Clarkson in for Garland. Taking a look at the Lakers. Up front, it's Kuzma and Davis. Rajon Rondo is out there with Che. And it's James in at the three, the small forward. Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sidelines.
Thanks, Kevin. Che, in the last game against the Raptors, put on a show. He finished with 70 points, but it was his season high in rebounds that really stood out. It's rare to see any player put up numbers like that. It's likely a game he'll always remember. Kevin?
David, we are...
What a jam!
You knew something good was coming, Kevin, right? Never get tired of LeBron James in the air doing wonderful things.
Now Clarkson, 11 points for him in that last game against Sacramento. But they'll get another chance. Yep, it counts. And that's 15 points for Kevin Love.
That's nice vision there. You see that pass, you make the feed before the defense has a chance to react, and that opens up a much better opportunity to score.
Davis finds James. Back to Davis. Some nice passing here by Los Angeles. Out left to the wing. Here's Rondo. They get it back.
And one,
they
there you go.
Foul, so he's got the and one chance here to make it a 3-point play.
And Kevin, they dialed up their activity this quarter. We're seeing them convert a lot of those second chance opportunities.
Garland, he's checked in for Matthew Dellavedova. And Los Angeles making a change here as well. Howard's checked in.
Well, we keep talking a lot about Anthony Davis and the fact that when he was a young player, he played the point guard position and then all of a sudden grew like 60 inches to play center position. You see that skill set show up now and again, but really what you're seeing now about AD is his maturity in the game, finding spots on the floor where he can absolutely be dominant and control any kind of offensive possession from wherever he is on the floor.
And here is Los Angeles now. At the conclusion of this game, they're off to Washington, where they'll face the Wizards. And they're playing through a string of road games that will be game 5 of the 6 on the road.
All right, there
Howard,
you go.
That's good.
Now you can tell he knows the game. Che, with great feel, finds the open man.
Well, Cleveland shooting 38% from the field, a pretty weak showing for them. And at Kentucky, Davis mostly an interior player, but he maintained, Brent, all along. He was capable of more than he showed in college.
There's no question about his skill set, and in the NBA, the opportunity, along with the transition of the NBA game, and especially the center position, he seems to be coming along at the appropriate time to show all of his wares off, Kevin.
The pass to Love. Here's Osman. James covering. Osman, the pass to Love. Launches it. The shot by Clarkson, no good.
Yeah, we're chipping some orange paint off the rim here, guys. He must be more patient on offense and trying to find ways to penetrate inside and get closer to the rim.
Give them credit. Offensively, they've been the more efficient team.
Yeah, that along with maintaining the pace of play right now, playing with tons of intensity.
Love outside. Shot from the wing. Jump shot is good that time. Love's got 17.
Disappointing as a player to have such a great game and still be trailing. Not over yet, though.
Trying to get open is Davis, and good that time. That's 29 points for Jay.
Yeah, the chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed with their offensive execution.
The Cavaliers shooting 31% in the second. Some poor shot selection for them in this quarter. Now, here's Garland. He's covered by Rondo. Clock at 6. Here's Love.
Oh, man.
And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up. That one on Davis. Brent, the league's been trying to clean up some of the physicality that we see, some of the jawing, but there are some players that do a great job of nonetheless getting under an opponent's skin.
I don't think, Kevin, over the past couple of years, we would deem the NBA as being more physical than at any other time. Would we say that?
I think that's fair.
We would never say that. But there are still irritants in the game. And the reason why those guys do that is because that's their competitive advantage. And that's the way the league is always going to operate. There are going to be guys out there who are going to use either their intellect to get inside your head or do things on a physical level that are going to cause you to think about what it is you're doing on the floor.
Exactly.
And when you find those guys, they're really interesting players to watch. You're not going to replicate their shooting form, Kevin. But in terms of sometimes their approach, there are things that you might be able to learn from a Draymond Green or a Marcus Smart.
There's no doubt. The Cavaliers shooting under 40% all in all for the game. Here's Windler, covered by LeBron.
Man, why is Love open, man?
Love, no luck. Los Angeles has gone 1-3 from way outside since the start of the second quarter. Davis, no good on the shot, a bit long that time.
He's going to be shaking his head on that one. Knows he missed an easy one.
Yeah, you can't make them all, and you for sure you'll want him taking that kind of shot.
Pass to Love. Knocked away. Pass break, the Lakers. Howard controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
Oh, it's tough.
Yeah, not easy trying to keep Howard off the offensive boards. He excels at using his muscles and his size to get great positioning.
Garland kicks to Love. Now the Lakers on the break. James with the ball. And that one drops for him. 33 points for Jay.
Changing ends quickly. He's rewarded with a high percentage look.
Yeah, the defense trying to do their best to slow him down. But when he gets room like that, you got to look out.
Passes to Love. Cleveland moving the ball around. 5 to shoot. Garland the pass to Porter. And another miss by Cleveland. Inside. And LeBron throws it down.
LeBron James, here's the report, Kevin. Still athletic.
Here's Windler. And that would have counted, but his shot was off the mark this time. And so it's the Los Angeles Lakers up by 33 points as the buzzer sounds. A huge lead for them. They've been playing some ferocious defense. It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away. Thanks, David. And we'll be back shortly following halftime to get the third quarter underway. Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is
yeah,
for this
it's not,
to
they're not going to come back.
And it probably has to happen quickly. Well, you look at Shea in this game. He has been everywhere.
What a menace he was on defense through the first two quarters. Just disrupting everything.
Yeah, and that's exactly what he wanted to do out there. Everyone he guarded looked uncomfortable.
Our second half of basketball and presented by Gatorade. Let's see who's all fueled up and on the floor to start the third. And so in the game for the Cavaliers, the duo inside, Love and Thompson. Clarkson is the two with Osman the three. And it's Garland in at the one.
I'd love to see them impose themselves a little more on the backboard. That's a great way to find confidence. Always a surefire way to get back in the game. Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
Yeah, the other team a bit concerned here. They're trailing, and the lead seems to be growing.
Love outside. Pass to Garland. Cleveland needs to get a shot off here. Love, no good.
Haven't been rebounding in this contest, huh?
Has been out of this world, 74% from the field. The Cavaliers pull it in. Love's got his eighth rebound here tonight. And if you're just joining us, we played over a minute here in the third. Osman, the pass to Love. Basket made. That gives him 7 field goals and 13 tries.
Appreciate the energy that Kevin Love is bringing to this contest, active and engaged on the inside and looking for his shot.
And there's the call on Jetty Osman. That's his first foul to the inside. For Los Angeles, they have made their free throws at a pretty good clip. They've hit 8 of 10.
And really, they haven't
they're really following me a lot in this one, huh?
On the season at about 76%.
We get a chance to come here early, so watching shoot around Kevin before the game, we were remarking that Shea was out there kind of cracking up with his teammates out there, enjoying the atmosphere. Really, really personable guy.
On the wing, Thompson. Taking a look at his stats, he's averaging around 7.5 points a game. Shot clock at 2. Here's Osman. Misses off the left iron.
Just a solid performance on the interior. The rebounding has been off the charts.
And LeBron gets it to go with the assist by Davis. LeBron's got 4 points in the quarter.
Well, you know Davis, and he knows, is going to draw the attention of multiple defenders, and that time connects with a teammate to get it done.
The shot by Clarkson, no good.
And it's another just bad decision on a night full of those. His shot selection tonight has been questionable at best.
That's 3 of 4 here to start the half.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time without a bucket.
All right, we're piling up our rebounds.
And here are the Lakers. They've outscored them 10 points to 2 during this run. And Kuzma slams it in.
They have a good plan going right now, and they're starting to create separation.
Well, game plan might have been good, but you have to bring it together. Right now, their chemistry is something to be admired.
They just got crossed.
Clarkson, and that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle, and 2 shots coming up.
Well, Clarkson likes to play with a lot of speed. He attracts the attention of the defense, and that's where he's getting the whistle.
And the Cavaliers making a change here. Nance has checked in. The Lakers also with a sub. DeMarcus Cousins, he's checked in for Anthony Davis.
And their balanced effort at both ends has hushed this crowd.
Well, all night long, in control of the pace, and you don't want to let go of that rope right now.
Garland, the pass to Thompson. And Nance kicks to Clarkson. Clarkson. From deep. No good on that one.
And you have to admire his confidence on that, but there's no way that's going to fall.
Coaches will tell you that's a bad shot, but when your teammates tell you that, you probably got to think about it.
Cleveland's gotten off to a very slow start from three-point range in the second half. They're 0 for 4. But Brent, you look at the size and athleticism of DeMarcus Cousins, and you can forget just how skilled he is.
Well, the interesting part about Cousins, and as his career goes on, especially coming off the injury, Kevin, what does he rely on? Well, when he came into the league, as you said, he had that skill set. He's going to rely more and more on that ability to shoot the ball and to still make plays so that he's still an impact player in the NBA.
Man, this is a blowout. Nothing much to say.
Here's Osman, covered by LeBron.
It was a scary start, though. They were hitting their shots. Then team takeover happened.
The pass to Garland for three. Once again, off the mark by Cleveland.
Yeah, and they've shown effort and aggression in the paint, really right from the
oh my gosh, that was ridiculous.
Right now, massive. And really keeping the ball hopping around here offensively. Still playing at an MVP level, LeBron James.
Institution here for Cleveland. Zizic has checked in for John Henson. Kevin Love comes in for Nance. Jetty Osman, he's checked in for Jarrell Martin.
Oh, shit.
And Jordan Clarkson in for Matthew Dellavedova. And Los Angeles will go for a different look here. Howard's checked in for Cousins. Kyle Kuzma comes in for JaVale McGee. James checked in for James. And it's Alex Caruso in for Avery Bradley.
Excellent on both ends of that play.
Yeah, the steal was sharp, but the slam topped it off.
And we say it time and time again, so I'll repeat it. Have to be careful with the ball, or this is what happens.
And Green now, top of the key. It's deflected. To the middle. Here's Howard. And Howard with the stuff.
And no answer for Dwight Howard. That deep inside the paint, always looking to throw it down.
Guys, we've seen a lot of turnovers in this one.
Yeah, focus, focus, focus. Just make the simple play.
Garland kicks to Clarkson. Here's Osman. Drops in the tray. Osman's got 9.
I think the defense has more concerns out there on the floor, and they give him a good open look from the perimeter.
Shay dishes to Howard.
Oh, boy.
I love the unselfishness.
Another team takeover, boys.
Coaches do as well.
Well,
not
oh,
just
shit.
Coach, but you can see it in the teammates, the way that they look at him, they appreciate it when he shares the ball like that.
And there's the call on Howard. That's his third foul so far. Bonus situation in effect, so we'll head to the free throw line for two. First one falls for him. A different look now for Cleveland. Thompson, he's checked in for Love. Porter comes in for Jetty Osman. And Knight subbed in for Garland. The Lakers also making some changes. Anthony Davis comes in for Dwight Howard. Rajon Rondo subbed in for Green. Here's Kuzma. Basket is good. The assist from Rondo. Kuzma's got 4 points now in the quarter.
Now you can't leave someone open around Rondo. He'll find them.
Clarkson passes to Thompson. Good D by Che. Los Angeles has gone into the three-point range 4 times since halftime and buried.
Oh, that was tough.
And he makes that one.
Strong work for him at the offensive end, helping them to maintain that lead.
Just 1 second between the shot clock and game clock. They get a hand on it. One-on-one fast break. Kuzma finds Davis. Lets it go from deep. Rebounded by Clarkson. Left side, Porter. And finished off by Porter.
So good court awareness that time from Brandon Knight. He's a creative guard who has a good feel for when his guys are open.
And so it's Jay making things happen for the Los Angeles Lakers. Setting up teammates and getting buckets. He is looking as determined as ever. And we'll be right back after this. And let's take this opportunity now to show you our State Farm Assist of the Game.
And the definition of teamwork right there, guys. I mean, what great communication between them, and what a beautiful feat.
The coaches talk about it all the time, but to be able to play with that kind of feel, nice play, collaborating, improvising, and organic.
All right. Yeah, basically playing with the second unit in this team takeover.
Into the fourth quarter, but stranger things have happened. Taking a look at the
no
Lakers.
Stranger things here.
Davis is out there with Jared Dudley. Then it's Jay. Then there's Kyle Kuzma. And it's Caruso in at the point. Martin with the bucket.
And the combination of his quickness and soft touch around the rim really allows him to pull off shots like that. A lot of players don't have the reverse in their arsenal.
Jay with it. Picked up by Thompson. And it goes down 2 points. 16 points for Davis.
Well, good positioning down low. That helps make the shot attempt a little bit easier for AD.
Knight looking for an opening. Here's Thompson. The putback.
Oh, man. Oh, my goodness.
That is really good work.
Where's
there
the rebounding, guys?
Glass.
Jay outside. Here's Caruso. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul. Well, when it comes to choosing, Brent, the MVP, the Coach of the Year, the Rookie of the Year, all these different great awards, do you like the current voting structure for these big awards right now?
I don't mind the current voting structure. I don't know how you get away from what it is that, in terms of handing people ballots to figure out who it is that they think have earned those awards throughout the year, Kevin. What I don't like about the structure is that you have media members who are voting on things that have huge financial ramifications for organizations. And when that stuff happens with a player who's going to earn a supermax contract because he made an all-NBA team, what you're going to start doing is restricting smaller market teams from being able to afford the ability to keep their star player with the team. And so that needs to be fixed, and fixed immediately.
I do not like the media. Wait a minute.
Wait.
I am the
you
media.
You are the media, Kevin.
Strike that. Let's rewind.
Can we delete that?
Back to Martin. The Lakers shooting an unbelievable 70%. You won't see a performance like this too often.
Jay showing a little bit of a mean streak right now to his game. Thinking dunk, getting dunk.
And we're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter now. Feeds to Martin. Shoots over Dudley. And it's Martin missing. The Lakers have gone 2 of 3 from the field to get the fourth quarter started.
And one. Aw, oh, that was
be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the
man,
foul.
I got some. I'm drawing some.
There are a few players now host
a lot of fouls.
Participate with those elements, with those vehicles during the season. Any thoughts on that?
I think it's great. I think it's fantastic for our fan base and for our players to have an outlet, to have conversations and share a little bit more about their personality. It grows them as people, I think, Kevin, especially I've listened to J.J. Redick's many times over,
yes.
And you learn something new, not only about players, but about their interests and how they're spending time. And I think if you were a young player, let's say you were a high school senior, or you're a college player, and you're listening to some of the things that guys are talking about and their experiences, I think it's invaluable for what it is that you don't know exists around a player in the NBA, and for you to start having considerations about how difficult the task is, how mentally taxing. So these things are great outlets for the players.
Six on the shot clock. Thompson is double. And Davis sends it back.
In your
That's
face.
A wonderful effort from Davis on the defensive end with that rejection.
Yet another bucket that gives him 51.
Making it look easy. And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
Down low, here's Windler, and a beautiful feed leads to a monster jam.
Textbook, nice pass, great catch, even better finish.
Shea's shot is off. The Cavaliers have gone 4 of 10 here in the final period. Not the time to go cold. To the paint, And Thompson throws it down.
Justin Thompson with some force on that one.
Inside, Davis. And another assist for him.
That makes 15 assists.
He's been one step ahead of the defense all game long.
Damn, we're hype.
Outside Knight. Brent, we have seen some players refuse to speak to the media. For whatever reason, where should that line be drawn?
Well, there is a role and a responsibility, I think, of every player in the league, Kevin, given that it's an entertainment industry and that people have jobs around this league to tell stories, to have access to those players. Now, every player doesn't want to talk or get into certain things, but their availability should be made and people should have access to them. Look, I don't want to take out the trash every Tuesday, but I understand I got to do it at home. And so players have a responsibility to their franchise to be a voice at times.
I always thought you were terrific with the media.
Well, I appreciate that, Kevin. Maybe that's how I got this job.
Capitalizing on the era, grinding out points, you got to love it.
That's why
we have a 60-point lead.
Turn it over to him because he's going to do stuff like that to make you pay just right down the throat. Well, they brought the double team to force the ball out of his hands, but failed to rotate off the pass.
Shade drives in, and a lot of contact on that one, so he'll shoot two here. It's going to go on Tristan Thompson.
Jay head down, nose down, wanting to get in there, not afraid to dribble in and earn some foul shots.
Henson checked in for Cleveland. JaVale McGee's checked in for the Lakers. And here is Knight. Pass to Windler. And oh, he blocked it and deflects off the backboard.
Hold that shit.
Passes it to McGee. And Che with the basket on the assist by McGee. 59 points for Che.
And running with a full head of steam, but
another team takeover
control.
For the third time.
He's comfortable at that speed. He's
that's our
so
record. Three team
before.
Takeovers.
Just an absolute blur in transition, and that helps get the rhythm going.
Dudley against Knight. Pass to Martin. Fade. It's hauled in by Los Angeles. Chase got 9 rebounds in the game. Getting it done. He kicks to McGee. Goes back up. He got it again. Sensational.
Make that 61 points.
Yep. Everything is going his way right now.
13 takeover, boys.
Porter dishes to Henson. Poked away.
That's defense.
You know, Brent, something other major sports do, receding during the playoffs. The highest seeds always will play the lowest seeds. And do you think the NBA should go down that road?
I think the consideration will still be there. I think that conversation is going to happen over the course of the next 2 or 3 years. I don't see it changing in that time, Kevin. But it's healthy to continue the dialogue to the point where maybe we do get there.
Mm-hmm. Left side, Martin. Rebounded by McGee. And Los Angeles guys, shooting has been just uncontainable. 72%. The Cavaliers shooting 44% in the fourth. The offense with some ups and
downs. Get that shit out of here, dog.
McGee with the block. Che drives in. And Che throws it down.
Fun to see Che get up and throw one down.
Outside Knight. Here's Henson.
Oh, shit.
Here's His basket is good. So a chance here for a three-point play.
How about that one? Able to maintain control and finish the play.
Brent, a lot of teams will be paying that luxury tax. And that is a tough thing for a lot of owners to swallow. Is this the best method to deter teams from going over the cap, overspending? And out spending smaller markets.
You're hitting the nail on the head, Kevin, because there are some teams, as much as you said it's tough for some teams to swallow, there are other teams that never see that pill.
Right.
And they're willing to go as far as they need to go in order to put a championship team on the floor. It seems
man, just pass him over.
But the question you have for me, was it a deterrent right now? I don't know if it's as significant as it needs to be. We know the repeater tax certainly hurts some teams, but there are still teams that are willing to spend, Kevin. That's really tough on small teams who want to avoid that at all costs.
Are we up by 71? I think our biggest was 81. To shut down biggest margin of victory. Well, we're in team takeover, so they're basically fucked.
Got a piece of it. Here's Knight. And another miss by Cleveland.
Oh, can't punish the defense for leaving him open that time. That's a frustrating miss for a really steady jump shooter.
Big miscommunication on defense. He recognizes it and quickly takes advantage.
Well, I know they don't have mobile devices out there for texting, so they might as well talk to one another, Greg.
To halt the run, JaVale McGee grabs the miss. McGee's got his sixth rebound on the night. Shea's shot is off. And so it's Porter bringing it up now for the Cavaliers. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Cavaliers will retain possession. The Lakers on D. Here's Windler. His three-pointer's off the mark. Shea inside. Sinks that one from the post.
Hard work inside on the basket. Shea silencing some of the doubters out there in terms of his effort.
Porter kicks to Henson. Knight wide open. Drills the three-pointer.
Kind of like playing in the rec league. Little to no defense on that possession. And the easiest three-pointer you can imagine.
Caruso, the pass to McGee, draws contact on the shot, and now a three-point play chance as he'll head to the line.
How about the concentration? He gets hit but stays with the play and gets the finish.
Not many players now signing shorter contracts in free agency. You've talked about this a lot. Does it make it harder or easier for the super team?
Well, I think it makes it easier because all of a sudden a star player from another team becomes available that you could latch him on to somewhere else.
Any examples you could throw out there? That
I don't want to get into the specifics.
Okay,
of it.
I understand.
I think we've seen it over the past 3 or 4 years with some of our star guys.
And yes.
I don't fault them because they're getting smarter. Players are a lot smarter about what it is that they can do with having the very few times, Kevin, that you have a say in your
I want to get
the
70 for the second straight game, boys.
You're going to play. And more importantly, the potential for what it is that financially
playing
you can
four,
make.
But and playing for a championship.
For a championship, for potentially the opportunity to play with somebody who you've always thought you could either elevate their play or they could elevate yours.
Damn, that's a dangerous foul.
Clearly a foul.
It is a foul.
Free throw, good. Shane.
Oh my gosh, I just got that.
And both free throws good for Shea.
Oh my gosh, I just got that.
1:14 left to play in the final quarter.
Well, guys, this was never really a contest. Just a total obliteration, if you will. And you can safely say mission accomplished now for the Lakers.
You don't see this kind of a blowout often. But tonight, this is a quality win across the board to deliver out this kind of punishment.
They definitely never changed the approach. They just kept after it and showed they were clearly the better team in just about every single category.
And this has been a beautiful thing to watch. This team all season long with a remarkable journey, including tonight. They'll have now won 70 on the year.
Really, they had their number this season. Two wins, a home win, and an away win.
And what a tremendous standout performance it was for Jay.
There isn't much else you want from someone. He gave it his all and was rewarded with a triple-double.
And the shot clock expired.
For 4 seconds, you want me in?
And here is Los Angeles now. From about 19 feet, on the money.
Finishing strong. This is how you want to close things.
Jumper coming in.
Definitely putting a stamp on this one. A very, very decisive victory for the club tonight.
And so it's the Lakers taking care of business here. This crowd was stunned by the manner in which their team was dismantled.
You know what? Shocking. I don't.
All right. So our next game will be against the Washington Wizards. This is actually the fifth game of our road trip. So tune into that one, guys. Thanks.